What's up guys, it's AMC9 here and welcome back to another video. So thank you all for getting me to literally 100 subscribers. I knew it, the day was going to come. I knew it. Can't believe it finally happened. So do you know how it happened? I'm going to literally watch a few songs that I literally CGI and literally John. Oh, and a show that got a film that was finally done in CGI. So the show are going to literally be Naughty, Thomas the Tank Engine, Fire the Sam, Bob the Builder, and Pokemon Pat, the movie. So, let's begin, okay? So, I got my daddy's laptop here. So the first one is going to be Naughty, because, you know how we know that Naughty was like popular in the 90s. So, this is like, okay? This is the intro. Okay. You can tell it's like CGI, but it's not the reboot because the difference. So it's like what? Yeah, you could tell what version of the show Naughty is. Here, let me just show you. And I'm just gonna call it Naughty, joining the fact you are how have Naughty in you how Naughty like the main character of the show, okay? Alright, let's begin. So this is like the third episode of the version of the CG. My version of Naughty, okay, anyway.
It is a lovely day in Toyland. So lovely that Noddy is outside gardening in his pajamas.
Yeah, you could tell by looking at Noddy was pretty much doing good today. And there was, and you might be wondering why she like gardening in her pajamas. You wait to see. And also, and what the hell, like, how was that at the beginning of the episode? Let me just show you what I'm talking about. Didn't know how that, what? So technically, it's not even like messy or something? I don't know.
Morning, Noddy.
Good morning, Mr. Plod.
Noddy Plod.
Noddy, it's morning. Why aren't you dressed?
It's such a lovely day. I didn't want to waste time changing. There's more time for fun if I don't have to get dressed and undressed every day.
Yep, now you know that we have for that guy, okay?
No good will come of this. Just you wait and see.
Oh, great. Look, there's the goblin.
If Noddy's not using his clothes, maybe we can.
I don't think they'll fit us.
No! I mean, I have a magic spell that can bring Noddy's clothes to life.
What good will that do?
If we can control Noddy's clothes, we can cause all kinds of trouble with them. And everyone will think it's Noddy doing it. Another.
Jeff, wait until the end, guy, okay? Because we're going to you.
Goblin-tastic!
I think I...
One, two, three.
Simon. Who that?
Now one, two, I'm three, not, I'm... 7, 6, 5. Make Noddy's clothes now come alive. Come here, Noddy's clothes.
Great. Here we go. No head, no neck, no hands, no legs. It's nothing.
Look, just there's quiet. Dizzy Bear's house. I'll bet she's sound asleep. Let's see if we can wake her up. Clothes, go and stir up those chickens.
This is the goblin. Oh boy, I think this is actually a fantastic episode. Oi, Oli! Not till the ending.
I'll wait here to see if that rascal comes around again tonight.
I bet he'll like how the goblin literally flame Noddy. Oh, great.
Halt in the name of Blood!
What? Literally, that's not Noddy. He will literally see the no head. Like, what? Mr. Clark, I think it's Noddy like what Mr. Clark did not even see the no did not even see a head like.
It's very late. What's the matter?
There's a troublemaker in Toy Town, and it's you.
Nope, it's not Noddy.
What?
I'm not the only one who saw you, Noddy. Hmm? Mr. Wobbly Man had a book stolen, and he saw a red shirt just like yours. Martha Monkey had her bike stolen, and she saw a yellow neckerchief just like yours. Even Tessie Bear had a fresh pie stolen, and she had a jingly bell just like yours.
But I've been home all night in bed, Mr. Plod. Hmm. Sound asleep.
Really? Hmm.
The face.
Then something funny is going on. Either you're telling a fib, Noddy, or someone else is wearing your clothes.
How could someone be wearing my clothes? They're right here and...
No, well, not. They're not here.
Oh, no. Where did my clothes go?
Easy. They came to life. I'm...
little Lee came to life.
Oh, don't mind about that. Just pretend you didn't see that, okay? That's the point. Okay, so yeah, everyone seems to be pissed off. I think I'm like,
gosh, everyone seems upset with me. Like I let them down.
Okay, now this part, should literally take seriously. Like, listen.
Everybody's naughty every now and then. Sometimes I'm bad, but soon I'm good again. You think I was naughty, naughty as can be. But I wasn't naughty. Don't be mad at me.
Okay, now, I think that's what the show... I think that's the way it was. Yeah, definitely so do. I think you do the same thing, Jonathan, unlike the other person.
Hello, Dinah Doll.
Tell me the truth, Noddy. Did you knock over my stall the other night?
No, you didn't. No, I closed. What?
No, I would never do that. I wouldn't.
True! Interesting.
I believe you, Noddy.
Well, wait, that's good, am I right?
Thank you, Dinah, but nobody else does.
I know. They all think they saw you causing trouble last night because they saw your clothes.
That's just it, Dinah Doll. I don't have my clothes. They're missing.
That means someone is pretending to be you.
That's not fair. I'm going to catch this troublemaker.
What?
I'll help you set a trap.
Thanks, Dinah Doll. But what kind of trap?
Last night, someone stole Tessie Bear's pie. So let's see if this hungry thief also likes muffins. Hey, everyone. I'm making Google Bear muffins tonight.
Oh, muffins.
The tastiest ones I've ever baked.
Oh. Interesting. I like how all the characters are like toys.
Did you hear that, Sly? I know where we're going to send Noddy's clothes tonight.
Do you think the troublemaker wearing my clothes will show up?
I sure do, Noddy. Look.
Oh, that's my clothes.
He looks just like me. Let's get him.
Magic.
Ask for clothes.
Clothes? What's making you move? Magic?
And whose magic is it? Big ears?
The goblins?
Of course, the goblins.
Listen, Noddy, I have a plan.
They went away. We don't want to. But you wish again.
Yeah, that's him. I can hear the bell.
Noddy and her cool magic.
It's the real Noddy.
And his clothes.
So, it was you goblins who caused all these problems.
It was us all right, Noddy. But you'll get into trouble.
Never tell anyone it was our fault.
Oh,
yes. It's 11
guess 2. I arrest you for the unlawful use of red shirts, yellow neckerchiefs, and jingly bells.
Now, what are you part of? No,
we're
this,
sorry,
no, we're
the troublemaker was you, Noddy. We should have known you would never do anything so naughty.
Now, the ending is funny. You know why? Because, watch.
Where are you going, Noddy?
I'm going to shake the spell off my clothes and put them back on where I can keep an eye on them.
But it's nighttime, Noddy. Time for your pajamas.
Oh, I'm tired of pajamas. I think I'll wear my clothes to bed instead.
Okay. so. Okay, so just cut to credit. Okay, so that's pretty much it. So that was the naughty one. Okay. So before I just end, I'm just going to literally just keep that. Next one is Thomas the Tank Engine. Okay, so we're doing Thomas next. This is the first episode of Series 14. James in the Dark.
The sun was setting at the end of another busy day on the island of Sodor. All the engines were very excited. Alicia Botti was to sing in the town square that evening. Sir Topham Hatt had a very special job for James.
James, you will bring Alicia Botti, the mayor,
and
the Sodor Brass Band to the concert. Yes, sir. It will be very dark tonight. You must have a lamp fitted. Yes, sir.
James to Dave Gibbon.
James puffed happily to the steamworks.
The movie went by James Dave Gibbon. Well, you wait and see at the end. No, I'm not dealing with the goddamn horrible ab. Stop it.
Hello, James, my friend. Your paintwork looks as...
I thought we were on the shit team, Mark.
That made James very happy.
That's because everyone must look their best for the concert tonight. Sorry, boss. Slipping a hook.
A workman brought a lamp for James. James didn't like the lamp.
This lamp will make me look silly. Everyone at the concert will look their best except me.
What?
The workman tried to fit the lamp to James's boiler.
Why the hell would he do it? Oh, sorry, guys.
Then to his buffer. Then to his funnel.
Oh, so this is the first time that the Thomas show actually did that.
The workman had tried his best, but still, James did not like his lamp.
It makes me look silly. I will not wear that silly lamp.
Also, you might be wondering why James
sounds puffed huffily out of the steamworks.
Also, you might be wondering why James actually sounds like a grown man. That's because this is the U.S. dub.
To pick up the very important visitors. Later at the next
station, Thomas.
James met an engine. The engine was Thomas. Thomas's lamp was shining brightly.
Hello, James. Where's your lamp?
It was dark now. James couldn't see which engine was there.
Lamps just make engines look silly. Goodbye, Henry.
I'm not Henry. I'm Thomas.
Who?
But James didn't hear. He was already puffing away into the darkness.
Oh, you gotta be kidding me. Now you know why James,
The evening became darker and
darker. Now you know why James, don't even give a...
James could see even less. Then there was trouble.
Here's a picture of the bad thing, guy.
There was a station ahead.
This is where I pick up Alicia Botti and the mayor. All aboard!
But James hadn't picked up Alicia Botti and the mayor. He had picked up Farmer McColl and his prize cow.
Oh.
James hadn't seen them on the platform. It was too dark.
You could tell why James is now a...
James could hardly see anything.
Head. It's a log of lock.
At the next junction, James met an engine. The engine was Edward. Edward had his lamp on.
Hello, James. Where's your lamp?
James couldn't see which engine was there.
Lamps make engines look silly. Goodbye, Percy.
Why would be Percy?
I'm not Percy. I'm Edward.
But James didn't hear. He was already chuffing into the darkness. The night was now very dark.
This is where I pick up the Sodor Brass Band.
But it wasn't the Sodor Brass Band. It was Farmer Trotter and his herd of prize pigs.
All aboard!
But James couldn't see them on the platform. James couldn't see anything. It was too dark. At last, James chuffed into the town hall. Sir Topham Hatt was waiting.
Here I am, sir. I have picked up all our very important visitors. James, what have you done? You have brought Farmer McCall and his cow, and Farmer Trotter and his pigs. I was expecting Alicia Botty and the mayor.
James felt terrible.
Bust my buffers. I thought a lamp made me look silly. Now I really look silly. I'm sorry, sir. This is my fault.
Sir Topham Hatt was cross.
Please, sir, I will have my lamp fixed. Then I will race like the wind to deliver Farmer McCall and Farmer Trotter to Brendam. Later, I will pick up the very important visitors.
Just then, Thomas puffed in. He had the workman with James's lamp in his cab. This time, James let the workman fit the lamp, and he didn't feel silly. Edward steamed in.
Hello, James. Your lamp looks good.
I know. Now I can see really well in the dark.
But you are still late, James.
James was worried. Then an idea flew into his funnel.
Sir, can Thomas and Edward pick up the visitors? And I will go to Brendam.
That's a good idea, James. Then you must come straight back here.
Yes, sir.
So, James set off for Brendam Docks. His new lamp glowed brightly in the dark.
Right, Jane, to see.
James arrived at the docks just in time.
Goodbye!
Okay.
Then, James pumped his pistons. He set off once more for the town hall. James chuffed happily along. Now, he could see everything in the dark. James liked having a lamp.
I can see how beautiful Sodor looks at night.
James puffed into the town square. Alicia Botty was singing sweetly. Then James gasped. There was another surprise. Thomas and Edward were using their strong lamps to light the concert.
Please, sir, may I shine my lamp on Miss Botty? Then everyone will see her for miles around.
Very well, James.
Now, James didn't feel silly at all. He felt very, very important.
Okay, that's it. Now make one final sound. So the way you want, and so I guess that was she with nine. The way why I picked she with nine because this was my favorite she with a final sound. It's just, it's my favorite.
When he hears that fire alarm,
yeah.
Sam is
always cool.
If you're stuck here,
and I'm gonna get out here.
We'll be there to help you. So who's
fun.
There it is. Neptune's new home. Ponty Pandy's all new ocean rescue center.
It's a bit big for just Neptune, sir.
Ah, well, it's also going to be home to two brand new vessels, Titan and Juno.
Ooh, how exciting. I can't wait to see them.
Uncle Sam!
Hello, you two. Any idea what's planned for the grand opening tonight? Well, Mike's organizing some fireworks.
And I'm making some of my fishy nibbles. Would you like to try one?
Ooh, don't mind if I do.
Oh, there goes Tom, taking off from the new helipad.
I wonder what he was doing here.
Tom was bringing the new Coast Guard. He'll be manning the Ocean Rescue Center.
Ooh, a new Coast Guard? Oh, I bet he'll know everything about sailor's knots. And have a big push.
Tell you.
I'm not sure he looks quite like that, Elvis. Hi, Ben Hooper.
Welcome to Ponty Pandy, Ben.
Where's the Coast Guard?
I am the Coast Guard.
But you haven't got a big bushy beard.
Fishy nippers.
Right then, firefighters. Let's get you inside so I can
communicate
with our new firefighting vessels.
And you two need to help me find the bunting.
Okay, Blanket and Charles.
Right then, we're off. Let's get out to the platform, Charlie, so I can get my fireworks sorted. Mike, this is Ben, the new Coast Guard.
So, you're doing the fireworks?
Oh, yes, but it's more than just fireworks. It'll be the Ocean of Flames.
Come on then, Mike. You'll need to put on a life jacket.
Why don't you take one of these? Brand spanking new, and they've got a light and a whistle so you can attract help if you need it.
Oh, very fancy. Is yours got a whistle, Charlie?
No, my whistle fell off.
And take care.
We'll get a new one, Charlie.
Three out there today.
What's he talking about? He means it might be a bit choppy.
Yep, choppy is a word.
Now this is Titan, our new firefighting
cool.
Where are the water tanks?
Titan doesn't have any water tanks, sir. She pumps water from the ocean.
Oh, does she really?
Marvelous.
Yes, and if you'd like to follow me...
Do you know any sailors' knots, Ben?
Of course I do. Basic nautical training.
Can you teach me one?
Of course. Let's start with a sheep shank. Imagine this end is a little brown eel.
Oh, I will. I love eels.
Little brown eel comes out of the cave, slips into the hole, out of the hole, and back in the cave again.
Oh, can I have a go?
Of course. Well, better go and make myself at home.
Right. Little brown eel slips into the hole.
Now let's go and see Juno, our new speedboat.
I think you'll find she's a jet ski, sir.
Who is back into the cave? Comes back out.
I'm not sure this is right. I can't seem to move. Wait for me. Get you.
Wait, I don't know how to get out, so I'm just going to use the, like, whip.
The platform's a bit small, Mike. Will it be safe letting your fireworks off on here?
I'm not going to be setting them off here. I'll be setting them off from the safety of the key. With this, my detonator.
Are you sure you don't need any help, Mike?
No, I'll be fine. I'll have these fireworks sorted in no time.
Well, if you're sure.
I'll just put this safely over here.
Well, about you.
It can go as fast as 50 miles per hour.
Would that be knots, sir?
Oh, yes.
Okay, so well, what
you all know, Neptune. So that's the tour finished. Where have you been, Crittenden?
Oh, sorry, sir. I got to Bintam. Tied up.
Oh, dear.
Ooh, it's getting a bit breezy. Will Mike be
be all right out there?
I'm sure he'll be fine.
They finished longer than me 1 hour. Oh, fine. Mike is blue.
Oh, look, Mom. Fireworks.
I
can't be going off yet, James.
They are. That's not just the
fireworks. I feel so great, Mom. Charlie, I will see what is happening.
I'll call Fireman Sam.
But
Mike Flood is trapped out at sea on a blazing platform. Mike Flood is trapped out at sea on a blazing platform.
Ben, you pilot Titan. Elvis and Penny, you man the water cannons. I'll take Juno.
Yo, here we go. Mike is blue.
Oh no, I'm getting off.
That did work. That lasts a lot of damage.
I'm at the platform, Ben, but there's no sign of Mike.
Just fire.
He's jumped on the water.
I'll take a look around. I'll hold her steady.
Penny, Elvis, you direct the cannons. That's more
fire. Help! I'm over here!
You got a whistle! What?
Oh, I got your whistle.
Help! I'm coming, Mike!
Hey, you tell the quality to crew on shooting
them. Nice job, man.
Oh, thanks, Bronwyn.
Sorry about your fireworks, Mike.
It was my fault. I should have been more careful with me button.
Well, it was a bit choppy out there. Probably a Force 3.
Does that mean there won't be any fireworks, Mike?
I'm afraid it does, James. The ocean of flame will never be seen.
It might, Mike. If I help you, we can go out on Titan.
Yeah, Titan's a good one.
Oh, I love a fishing boat.
Okay, so then.
No, Neil slips into the hole.
You should do the honors, Sam.
I will, sir. Attention, everybody.
Oh, what's going to happen?
I now declare the Ponty Pandy Ocean Rescue Kay. Center open.
Yay! Open now. You're literally open.
We're up.
The fire world.
That really does look like an ocean of flame, Mike. But this time, I won't put it out.
I'm stuck again.
Then they just cut to the credit. Follow the clue. They'll be there to rescue you. Alright, now that one is literally blocked the road now. Now this is the right day built here, this is not the 2015 reboot. The reason for that because apparently it was the first time that Bob entered the world CGI era. Which is
Bob the Builder, can we?
Alright, the reason why I'm doing this one, I think one because
we fix it! Bob the Builder, yes, we can.
Yeah.
Lofty and Wendy.
fun. Working together, they get the job done. Bob the Builder, can we fix it? Bob the Builder, yes!
I might make a video, guys, talking about the canon and non-canon series of Bob the Builder, okay? Hey, so this is the version, one version of the way they built serial intro, actually a second version, but I'm not going to do like two with the way they built serial because that one should be the thick of it.
Oh, everything's such a mess after that big storm last night.
That was funny, you know why? Okay, it looked fine, but however.
So, that's what the old pier looked like.
But now it's gone.
Yes, Mark. We need to build a new pier. How by long did it
disappear? Well,
we'd better hurry then.
Yeah. Can we fix it?
Yes, we can.
So this video is going to be so full for Kid Guy because...
Scoop, I need you to clear all the broken bits from the old pier platform.
No, Frog, Bob.
And Dizzy, can you pour some more concrete to make it level?
Okay, Bob.
Then I'll make it nice and flat.
What about me, Bob? You'll be lowering the new wooden posts into the sand lofty. Then we'll build the new pier on top.
Let's get started.
Bob, why did the pier fall down? It was really old, Lofty, and the wooden posts had gone rotten. See? Oh. The wood's gone all soft.
That's what happens when you stay in the water too long.
Yeah,
watch out, Buck. Don't get your wheels wet.
I knew getting wet wasn't a good idea.
We'll have to work fast while the tide is still out.
Does the sea move?
Yes, Lofty. At high tide, the water comes right up here. At low tide, it's further away.
Oh, right.
True.
So, the sea isn't here now, but it's coming back. Ah! I don't want to get wet and fall apart like the old pier did.
And we do know that apparently 2008 was the year for the beginning for Tom and Farmer Sam and Bob the Builder entering the world of CGI. I mean, season 12 of Tom is apparently all the characters and faces were CGI. But however, they switched to full CGI later on. And later on for season 13.
Just where that float is.
Okay, Bob.
They're walking. I like water.
That's it. Closer, Lofty.
Never mind, Lofty. We've got a few more.
Yeah.
Hello, Bob the Builder. Oh, yes, we do need some more. I'll send Lofty. Thanks. Bye.
the supplier's yard and pick up some more posts and planks, please.
Okay, how do I get there?
By the way, just to let you know, that apparently the way they built Siri is also not canon to the Mother series, the way he flew that, because the like, the two way different way, like, you don't know, you have to, like, watch the way they build Siri over and over again just to see the difference, okay? We've never been to you. What does that mean?
Which way is it? That way? No, this way, I hope.
That looks like this. That looks like. It looks like nothing.
Hello, Bob the Builder. Oh, right. Okay, thank you. Supplier's yard. Lofty hasn't even arrived yet.
He wouldn't take the coast road, Bob. He went through the hills instead.
Oh. Well, Grabber's on his way to look for him. But I wonder why he went the wrong way.
It wasn't that way. So, it must be this way.
Bubble, mate. Where have you
been? Oh, Grabber! I've been trying to find the supplier's yard.
Don't worry. Follow me.
Take the coast road, like I said.
Because, it goes near the sea.
Lofty, you're back. We've got to fit the last of those posts. The tide's coming in.
Uh-oh. Well, they, why you guys built? Well, they built my hurry. So. Lofty B gray. That's why I call the gray one. This is a Lofty or actually Mott.
Oh, going for a swim, Lofty.
What? Oh no!
Well, the water's not that bad, right? What? What?
Oh, Lofty, that won't happen to you.
Oh, won't it?
No. Wood can fall apart in the water eventually, but your tires aren't made of wood. They're waterproof.
Oh.
True, join the fans, for my boots are waterproof, and for every single thing. Every single thing that has wheel, the wheel are waterproof.
You.
Okay, so well, if I can bike back to normal.
There. It looks just like the old one. Well done, team.
You were really brave, Lofty. I didn't know you were worried about the water.
Yeah. Sorry we splashed you.
Oh, it's okay. I'm not worried anymore.
Okay, so the ending was so funny. So, okay, so I'm gonna write the query. Okay, so now the query I make. Something like the third one we did, because the only one had like the query, the comic one did not have the query. The Sam one literally had the query, and this one had the query. Yep, Hit Entertainment. The one that owned the original, the company that owned Little Lee, Bob the Builder, the Whitehall one. Anyway, let's see the, not a good look, the green pig. Anyway, look good. He's the funny father.
There is definitely something funny going on around here.
The Pokemon Path movie might have to be the funniest film ever. Did you see that? They're funny. Well, where did they go? Wait. Why do you say hello? Jeff bought him out.
You should have stopped her letters, Matt. You need to be willing to stop at nothing to begin, Shoebiz. I learned that from Hannah Montana. Ah, see how well you sing from inside a box, you little.
There go Papa and Jeff. It turned to Carmichael like that.
I won!
going to do. I'm just going to also record this because I want the video to be like 1 hour. Okay, so. Okay. Yeah, Louis, your pet.
He isn't coming. Hey, are you okay, mate? I don't know.
Josh! Just one of the tables. Break your leg, pet.
Oh, 420 was interesting.
I should talk to Mr. Brown.
Oh, no. You're not ruining this now. I finally got that fool of a CEO where I want him. If it were up to him, SDS would stay a quaint little delivery service dedicated to customer service and the human touch. Blah!
But I thought that's what all this was for. To help keep SDS the way it's always been.
Your publicity was to make people love Postman Pat. Now, I can replace all of SDS's human workers with Patbots. And when I become CEO, SDS will become the biggest, most profitable company in the world.
No, I won't go along with that.
Sorry, Papa.
Dimension. I don't need you anymore, either.
What do you mean by hello, Pat? You can count on me. The special delivery always gets through. Mission accomplished.
The high point.
Nice working with you, Pat.
Don't worry. Hey, you can't do this.
Yeah. Did you will not see my entire face.
What have I done? I've given up everything and everyone who cared about me for this. And I don't even recognize myself anymore.
This is me.
Oh, I've been such a fool.
I'm good. Okay, so that is 3 months. So, yeah, I can't believe it might have been the longest video I should ever create. Typical, literally 1 hour. 1 hour. So, that's 3 months, guys. So, hope that you enjoyed this video. So, if you do, make sure to like and subscribe. And I'll see you in the next video, guys. This is AMC9 signing off.